Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Debralee Scott, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Bulifant as we play the star-studded big money match game 77. And now here's the star of match game 77, Gene Reagan.
Hey, John. There we go. Thank you. I thank you for joining us. You're going to have a good time?
You are obviously loved.
Yeah,
oh, thank you. Aren't
you
nice?
Yes, yeah, they're a good, very good nice bunch. They love you, too.
Thank you.
I saw him yesterday.
Did you hear that silence?
You were tennising and I was golfing.
I was tennising and he was golfing.
That was
yes.
Fun.
You have a good game.
Yes, I enjoyed it very much.
Good. You don't get sunburn when you play, do you?
No. I avoid that. I put sunscreen on.
You wear those big floppy hats?
No. That's Brett.
Oh, I see. Now, what is this you're wearing?
Now, this is a poncho, and I get more fan mail, and I wish I couldn't. People ask me, write and ask me, if I have the pattern. I don't. I'm sorry. I don't have the pattern. It was a present, and it was bought in a store.
Was it hand-knit?
It was hand-knit somewhere, but I don't know where, and okay. I don't know how to do any
so
of that
you don't want
stuff.
Prisoners in Chino.
Prisoners in Chino.
But I've been writing to a lot of people to tell them, but I want to let them know, no, I don't. I don't know.
Well, I'm glad that's no all more out mail in the open. Yes. I was so concerned about
it. Yeah, no.
Let's hear. Put on the
let's top. Welcome our two players over here and give them a brisk round of applause, Rich Orloff and Tina Montiel.
Hello, champ.
Hello, Gene.
Listen, Rich.
Yes, Gene?
These suits will come back.
Yes.
No, I'm only kidding.
Thank you.
Rich has got a lot of money, $5,600, and he's very happy about that. What are you going to do with that money?
I'm going to fondle it and look at it a lot and pay back some loans, put some of it away, buy a brandy snifter, and then get drunk.
Boy, that'll buy a lot of brandy. Okay. Now, Tina Montiel here. She's from up there near Sacramento, California.
Right. Davis.
And she's down here with a whole bunch of people. Are they still here?
They're still here, I hope.
Yeah, there. She's got a lot of rooters there. She's had her first round question. As usual, she found it difficult.
Right.
And he will find his to be difficult, too, right after we find out about this. Here we go. Bing. There it is. Rich, that's yours. You can have A or B. A, you want A? Okay, he said A. All right, here it is. Poor dumb Donald. He couldn't find his electric toothbrush, so he stuck an electric blank in his mouth. Now remember, this is a round one question. And you may roam far afield.
3 days ago.
3 days ago.
You got your hair cut. See, acting teachers know everything. If you figured it out, that's when it was.
Really?
Think
what does that
it
mean?
I don't know what he means. Yes, right. Poor dumb Donald, he couldn't find his electric toothbrush, so he stuck an electric blank in his mouth. Remember?
I'm all through.
It's a round
not
one question.
Yeah.
All right. No. Right. Okay, here we go, Rich. Poor dumb Donald couldn't find his electric toothbrush, so he stuck an electric blank in his mouth.
Hairbrush.
Electric hairbrush. Yes.
Hot comb.
Yeah. You say you want to be a comedy writer. Is that what you
yes
say?
Yes. I never said I was good at ad-libbing.
Okay. He said an electric hairbrush.
Oh, I don't know about that. I said electric razor.
Electric razor, yeah. Well, you know, a question like this, Rich, anything electric, like electric razor is good, but electric hairbrush is a little weird.
what is an electric hairbrush?
He doesn't know. He just said something electric, an electric hairbrush. I've never seen one myself.
Okay.
Yeah.
I said an electric drill.
Electric drill is okay?
That's good, hon, because you could stuff it in your mouth and blow
anything
it
electric,
up.
Charles.
I can't use an electric hairbrush.
Oh, you can't? Why is that?
Well, go ahead. Why would you think? Say it.
Oh, no. Oh,
because he don't have
because,
no hair.
No, the fuse is all blue in my house.
Oh.
Drill.
Hairbrush is a kind of a weird answer, but what the heck.
I loved it.
I thought it was quite good. Debralee.
I said electric shaver.
An electric shaver. So we have two of those so far.
Yes.
You matched Dick Martin.
We're on the same wavelength.
From Mary Hartman. What do you say?
Electric blanket.
Electric blanket.
I knew it.
That is the dumbest answer I have ever heard.
You couldn't put an electric blanket in your mouth, could you?
No, everybody
just
would
use a corner.
Just use a corner?
No, everybody would think your tongue was coated.
Oh. Charlie Brown puts an electric blanket in his mouth, doesn't he?
Yeah.
He does? Is that electric? It's got a cord on it?
Yeah.
It's Linus.
My goodness.
Linus does. I beg your pardon.
I said blanket. Yes.
You're dumb.
Oh, dear. Well, neither one of them did well with their first round questions. I don't want to say we got two dummies up here, but... Hello, Tina.
Hi.
Now, Tina, you may have A or B.
I think I'll try B again.
B again?
Right.
This is the second final round. Everybody plays. Mm-hmm. Ted said. That performer was so boring.
How boring?
Ah, shut up. Who asked you?
As boring.
That performer was so boring, at the end of his act, the audience gave him a blanking ovation. That performer was so boring, at the end of his performance, the audience gave him a blanking ovation.
Gotcha.
I say?
Look at Mike.
I'm finished. The audience can see all this.
Looks great.
I never saw his
act. Oh, gosh. All right. Well, there's two.
Yep. There are indeed. You know, look at the person you're playing with and see. Well, the object is to match the player over there. And write and do it now.
I'm doing it.
Okay. Hello, Tina.
Hi.
Ted said, that performer was so boring, at the end of his act, the audience gave him a blanking ovation.
Walking out ovation?
Walking out ovation.
Or sitting? Sitting?
Listen, have you got your bus fare back to Davis? You have. Okay. All right. She said a walking out ovation.
Ah, very clever.
You've heard of them, have you?
Yes,
yes.
Woo.
It's woo?
W-O-O.
Walking out ovation.
Woo. I wooed them.
Yeah, woo. An acronym.
I said sitting ovation.
A sitting ovation. Now, Tina, you've heard of a standing ovation.
Uh-huh.
Well, you see, the opposite of a quiet one would be a sitting.
That was my second choice.
Yeah, that was your second choice? Good luck.
Oh, hello there. Boy, Tina. Yeah, and they use cattle prods and everything, but they just sat there.
Chuck.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I have chosen a yawning ovation.
A yawning ovation? A yawning ovation was good. Sitting ovation was excellent. Debralee, I suppose you have a good one, too.
Well, I concentrated on Tina, and I think, I'm sure this is the same. Leaving ovation.
A leaving and walking out.
See?
You really did get your ESP going.
Yep.
You're as weird as she is.
She got one.
You're trying to
tell Joyce. Really boring.
Boring.
You get a sleeping ovation.
A sleeping ovation. Very good. Indeed it is. Now, speaking of weird answers, show and tell.
Not as weird as any of these, but similar to Richard's, a lying down ovation.
Lying down. She was looking for leaving or walking out and got one, strangely enough. And Rich,
strangely
when we come back. Yes.
Wait a minute.
When we come back from this commercial massage, you will have to match one celebrity to tie and two to win. Now this. Hello there. Here we go. Rich,
yes,
ready?
Gene, I sure am.
All right, you have to match one to tie and two to win. Are you ready?
Oh, I'm always ready.
Everybody plays because he didn't match anybody in the first round. Here it is. New York City is such a strange place. Even the blanks accept master charge. New York City is such a strange place. Even the blanks accept master charge.
Once again, may I say it, please, Johnson?
Now you will notice I'm
you're familiar with New York City. It's such a strange place.
I was born here.
Even the blanks accept master charge.
You've just proved his point.
That's not nice. You shouldn't have done that because that doesn't wash off. You gotta have turpentine. No, it's terrible. No. Somebody did that once, put a mustache on me, and we had a terrible time getting it off. I don't even remember who it was. Was it you?
No, of course not. I'm smarter.
Betty White did it, yes.
It's this chair. It makes you do those things.
Right. Okay, Rich, here it is. One to tie, two to win. New York City is such a strange place, even the blanks accept master charge.
Muggers.
Muggers. You to muggy or to muggor?
I didn't have muggers.
You didn't have muggers?
No, these are a representative of the rug industry, the hookers.
Oh, the hookers. Okay. What do you say?
Back to his old ways.
That's a rather amusing answer, however.
It's mirth-provoking, but it doesn't match the man who's on his way to the funeral, does
that's,
it?
That's right. Yeah.
The trick is to match. Mother!
There's one. Tie score. Now, Charles, it's all in your hands. What are you counting?
14, 15 women that want to know exactly if they can find the pattern for the ceramic. Mugger!
Mugger wins the game. What the rest of you have? Tina!
Yes?
Have a good time for the rest of your stay. We're going to send you lots of gifts.
Thank you.
And we thank you for being with us here on Match Game.
I enjoy being here.
Goodbye, Tina. Yeah. You saw it. Spot there, old bean. You've been through this before. You know how it goes, so let's get right to it. There was a bunch of people in here one day. And we did a little questioning among them, did a little poll, a little research to get their best response to this. It's blank time. It's blank time. Yeah. Now, the answer they gave us most frequently will get you a total of $500 if you match it. If you match the second most popular answer, you get $250. And $100 for matching the third. And remember, three of the six can help.
Brett?
There was a song and he goes, da 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 da. What is that?
It's howdy doody time.
It's howdy doody time.
It's howdy doody time. Da da doody doody.
Thank you, dear.
Charles?
It's about time.
It's about time.
And Richard?
It's post time.
It's post time. That's it. Very, very popular thing there at Santa Anita and all those places. All right, so it's howdy doody time, it's about time, and it's post time are the three. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own.
It's about time.
It's about time is Charles' answer. Let's find out if we got it up there anywhere. May we see the bottom one, if you please. It's party time.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's it. Right. Let's see if we got it. It's about time under the $250 number. It's howdy doody time. Okay, Brett, there it is. Last chance for about time. Slide it, Earl. It's about time. Very good. Very good. Now you pick up another bundle here. You're up to $6,200, Rich. And you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. $5,000, right?
Yes, that's a lot of money.
It is indeed. There, yes. That'd give you a lot of brandy nifters, right?
Yes.
Okay. Now, you have to match one person exactly.
Richard.
Here we go.
Post.
Post time. A little late. All right. Stand there. I stand here. He sits there. Worth $5,000 to this young fella. Good luck to you, Rich. Here it is. Blank Fleming. Blank Fleming. F-L-E-M-I-N-G. Blank Fleming. Finished. Now, Rich, the answer that will match Richard Dawson gets you $5,000. Got to be the same one, though.
I realize that.
There it is. Blank Fleming.
Peggy.
Peggy Fleming, Olympic ice skating champion. Peggy Fleming, he says.
I checked with, and I was with one or two of them, but he said he's a writer.
Right.
You know, so I said, did I ask you who that
he
was?
He said, yes, who's the ice skater?
And who did I go with? Ian Fleming.
Ian James Fleming. Right.
I don't write that type of stuff.
I didn't say you wrote it. I thought you might have someone read it to you. Right.
Did you think of Ian Fleming?
Oh, I certainly did. Yeah.
Dorothy Hamill was a big skating star at this Olympics, you see, and I thought Peggy might not be there.
Right. Okay.
Still, I won $5,000.
There are two or three good answers. He's not complaining. He's very happy. He's got $6,200. Aren't you happy, Sarah? I'm
extremely happy.
All right. Let's welcome a new player. No, let's get a little commercial message here, and then we'll continue. Here we go. Oh, here we go. Let's all say hello to Kathy Niddle over here. Applause, applause, applause. Hello, are you, Kathy?
Fine, thank you.
Where's Kathy from?
I'm from Rosetta, Pennsylvania.
Rosetta?
Yes.
Where's that? Is that?
Oh, it's a small Italian town in the foothills of the Pocono Mountains.
Oh, that's a very pretty part of America.
Yes, it is.
And what else about Kathy?
I'm a graduate of the University of Miami.
Mm-hmm.
I'm single.
Right.
And I'm out here visiting some friends, but I would love to stay if I could find a job. Do you have anything available?
Do I have anything I had at my house? The job you had at your house?
It's difficult getting that job filled.
Yeah, but I don't think she does windows.
She won't have to do windows.
I'll take it.
She says she'll take it there. Okay. All right, we'll negotiate later. Good luck to you here, my dear. You may have A or B in round one.
B, please.
B it is. Here we go.
Oh, good. Ted said.
Ted said, no.
No.
Little Billy.
Ah.
Little Billy, you know him.
Yes.
Strange kid, isn't he?
Yeah.
Oh, very strange. Strange little kid. On laundry day, just for fun, he ran his blank through the ringer.
Just for fun.
Just for fun.
Come on now, write an answer down there.
Just for fun, right? Okay.
On laundry day, just for fun, he ran his blank through the ringer. Okay.
Well, all right. I'm having a hard time with this.
What happened to you?
I don't know. My mind is, but I match.
Yeah.
It takes time. All right.
She's very conscientious because, you know, they all are that way. Hard working. Yeah. Yes. She comes here to.
Is where you live anywhere near Stroudsburg?
Yes.
I used to live there.
Here, Kathy.
Yes.
Little Billy, wait.
I'm sorry, it was a little delay here.
Really?
Time warp.
Little Billy is a strange little kid on laundry day just for fun. He ran his blank through the ringer.
His pet dog?
His pet dog. Yeah. All right. Nothing wrong with that. That's not a bad answer at all. Right, Dick?
Yes, but he was stranger than that.
Oh, how strange.
He was strange enough to run his sister through the ringer.
Oh, yes. Yeah. That takes a lot of daring and imagination.
No, he was really strange, and he was very, very tall for his age, and very, very strong. And he wrote his sweet, kind, adorable, loving mummy through the ringer.
Mummy, right through the ringer.
He said, come on, hon. He said, all right.
Chuck?
That should come out in hardback. Sister.
Sister, we're looking for a pet dog, Debralee.
Well,
he ran his pet dog through the ringer, according to Kathy Niddle.
Well, I never had a pet dog. I had a pet cat.
Oh, close. Yeah.
Meow.
A meow cat. That hurt
meow.
A lot there. Okay. What do you say?
Cat.
That's two cats there. We're looking for a dog.
He had a terrific day, didn't he?
Yes, he did.
He said his rubber snake.
Yeah, terrific. So that's how it goes, Kathy. You win some, and you lose some. And you lost a lot there. Ready, Rich? Here it is. Everybody plays again. Did you hear the tiny Tom Thumb went blind, and instead of a seeing-eye dog, he has a seeing-eye blank. Tiny Tom Thumb has a seeing-eye blank. Tiny, tiny.
Tiny, how tiny was it?
Oh, very tiny.
I'm ready, Gene.
Thank you, Charles. Hi. Hi. Okay. Everybody ready, Rich? Did you hear the tiny Tom Thumb went blind, and instead of a seeing-eye dog, he has a seeing-eye...
Mouse?
Mouse is not bad, Dick. He said a mouse.
Well,
pretty good answer.
He's not a bad writer after all. I said mouse.
Oh, that's one for him. Brett?
Oh, shucks. I thought a mouse, and I said roach.
Roach is a good one. Chuck?
Come along.
I had to draw fast. Mouse.
A mouse, okay. I got the point there. All right, looking for a mouse.
He's tiny. Cockroach.
Cockroach, yeah, he was smaller than that. Yes.
Seeing eye uncle, seeing eye aunt.
Seeing eye aunt, yeah. Little mouse.
He was very, very tiny. A seeing eye flea.
Flea. So there we are at the end of round one. 2-0 is the score. Round two will follow, but right now, this. How do you do?
How do you do?
Now I ask you.
Yes.
Would you like to do this again?
Yes,
definitely.
I would.
You would?
Yes.
How about tomorrow?
Tomorrow would be
great,
a good time.
Great.
Can you make it tomorrow?
I can make it tomorrow, too.
I have an appointment.
Swell. You have an appointment.
Right, but I can break it.
All right. You both come back tomorrow. Can you come back tomorrow?
Oh, I'll say goodbye now.
All right. Goodbye now. Join us tomorrow for Match Game 77.